Sir, just give me 2 minutes, then we start the session, sir.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, sir. So good morning, everyone, and thank you for joining us today. This is our sixth day of teachers training program, and this is the last day. So last three sessions we have left. So thank you very much to be a part of this teachers training program from since last 5 days. So welcome back again to this teachers training program on recent advances and application of machine learning and IoT in mechanical engineering, offering by a joint venture of AICTE and RGVP Bhopal, and organized by Sagar Institute of Science and Technology, Gandhinagar, Bhopal. So myself, Nitin Kumar Sahu, I am Assistant Professor in Mechanical Engineering Department, Sagar Institute of Science and Technology, Bhopal. So first of all, I would like to brief you about today's sessions. Today we have three sessions, session number 25, 26 and 27. First two sessions will be delivered by Dr. M. Sri Kumar. He is Associate Professor, IIITDM, Kanchipuram. Sorry. The first two sessions will be delivered by Dr. Suresh Gavare, sir. He is Assistant Professor, Manit Bhopal, and the topic will be IoT application practical approach. And then the second topic will be machine learning classification with support vector machines. And the last session, that will be the last session of this TTDB program, will be session number 27, and that will be delivered by Kanral V. Venkat, is Director, Faculty Development, AICTE, and the topic will be implementation of NEP, that is National Education Policy 2020. So after the three session, there will be a test. Okay, the test will have around 50 questions and around 1 hour. The time duration will be 1 hour, and after that there will be valedictory session. It may be possible first we will do the valedictory session, after that we will conduct the test. And the third session, the session number 27, timing will be slightly changed. The timing will be 1:30 to 2:30. Okay, and for that session we will forward you the Zoom link on the WhatsApp group. So before starting this session, I would like to introduce our speaker, Dr. Suresh Gavare. So Dr. Suresh Kumar Gavare, he is Assistant Professor, Department of Electrical Engineering, Manit Bhopal. He completed his BE in Electrical Engineering, then completed M.Tech and then PhD in Electrical Engineering. He has total 18 years of experience. His specialization are power quality monitoring, solar PV systems, analog and digital electronics, IoT applications and machine learning. He published 12 papers in international journals and 22 papers in international conferences. He is a member of IEEE, and the country he visited, Thailand, for performing, for presenting the different papers, and also attending the conferences. Number of PG projects, he guided 16 M.Tech theses and 20 B.Tech projects. And as far as the PhD project is concerned, he has guided 2 PhD scholars. And one thesis he is assisting for PhD scholar. Project and consultancy work, he has completed 2 project and consultancy work. First is the weather station, that is funded by MHRD, and second one is the smart microgrid hybrid system, that is funded by TechCube. Second, apart from that, he has other responsibility. He has performing different other responsibilities also. He worked as a hostel warden also in 2014 to 2016. He is a departmental examination control coordinator 2014 to 2019, lab in charge of microprocessor PLC lab and renewable energy lab, and departmental coordinator of training and placement since 2017 to till date. Apart from that, he is a member of editorial board of newsletter Manage Bhopal, mentor of first startup company that is Prayogik Limited at Rolta Inclusion Center, Manage Bhopal. He is also a reviewer of IEEE conferences and journals, and organized two STTDP as a coordinator and delivered 5 expert lectures. So with this introduction, I would like to request sir, kindly proceed the session.
Thank you. Thank you very much for kind introduction. Myself, Dr. Suresh Kumar Gavre. Basically, I am from the electrical background, but my interest keenly on the novel technology or cutting edge technologies. So I have just developed my interest over there and work on it, on either the IoT, Internet of Things, or the machine learning, because these are the cutting edge technologies. We are very popular in present scenario. Okay, so I'll just discuss about in very brief introductory part of IoT, by which we can just develop our own IoT node, because it is a problem, or you can say it is a lack of knowledge that our students, our faculty, our researchers just afraid that how will we make the hardware in this corona pandemic season. Okay, so just I'll just give you the demo also, how can we develop the one IoT node to just show that we can transfer the temperature or any quantity of current or voltage by our own using very low cost components, isn't it? So it's a main motive of my presentation. Sorry, is it visible? My screen is visible?
Still not right now. No, sir. Yes, sir. Now it is visible.
Yeah. Is it visible?
Sir, I think your camera is off right now.
Yeah. So should I on it?
Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Now we are able to see you, sir.
yeah. Thank you. Just I am moving towards my slides. Now is it properly visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So as I suggested that it is important to develop a kind of IoT module, because it is very much necessary to get into it while we see a entire scenario of power system along with the connected load. So I have just suggested that now people are moving towards the electrical vehicles as the price of petrol is hiking. And so much we are evolving towards the new technologies and merging towards. So that is my keen objective over here. And presentation topic is low cost IoT setup for EV monitoring. So here I'll cover these contents: Internet of Things, what is the Internet of Things, why it is important over there in the field of electrical vehicles, and specific application in electrical vehicles, what are the research scope in this field, because as gathered researchers are belong to mechanical engineering or transportation, so they keen on that what's the new thing coming up in this area. So it is electrical vehicles, and IoT is the enabled technology by which we can fuse between the our classical transportation system and our smart grid technologies. So I'll just give a brief, and further IoT in hardware enabling technologies. What are the technologies which are already working on it for the communication, for the control, and all other aspects? Isn't it? So I just wanted your two-way communication learning so that we can just understand the things and we will express our question and queries at that moment, and I'll try to solve, or I'll try to give the answers also in between. So that is a two-way communication with us also, isn't it? So enable technology we'll discuss, then technological challenges of IoT and low cost IoT setup for the EVT, electrical vehicle monitoring. Okay, so for the monitoring purpose, I have especially chosen the temperature monitoring, as the heat aspects are, you can say that that is a major concern, that by using some sensors we can just draw the measurement value and transfer it to our cloud. So main objective of this session would be the to make a hardware setup to transfer our data on cloud, and from anywhere else we can just retrieve those information. So first question is that what is the IoT? So while we say that IoT, that simple mean that it is an Internet of Things based system. It's proposed to have an interconnection computing devices like our computer, our server, with a physical device with unique identifiers. And it is an embedded system with electronics, software, sensor, actuator, and the network connectivity, which enables the objective to communicate with each other, collect the data, exchange the data, and analyze those data which is being collected. So this is our basic configuration of Internet of Things. We have three basic requirements while we discuss about the IoT scheme over there. So first thing is things. Things, that means that a part by which we are having the sensors. Second is the people who are observing via internet at the remote location for analysis. And one is the common platform, it is cloud, cloud service, where we just sending our information and it is free to use by the other users, or you can say the other people can easily retrieve those information by using their own ID, or you can say the having a mail ID or the cloud ID at which they are sending their information. So it is a two-way communication between the IoT application, IoT software, and IoT enabled technology, or you can say the hardware. So as far as hardware is concerned, so we are proposing here the very low cost hardware. As we know that the more precise and accurate and other kind of the systems are also available over there, but they compromise with that particular data handling. So here we are will discuss that how a very low cost system is enabled to get the data efficiently and within our range also. So next is to develop the concept of it, what is the IoT and how it works. So as earlier I have said that the cloud is an intermediate where all the data are in, stored over there, and there the things, that means the device, or you can say the electrical vehicles, where we are getting the information or sensing the voltage, current, temperature, humidity, sound, audio, any kind of the information we are getting from, we will just send it to the cloud. So objective is that to get the information from the cloud. So further that, the application part, once get the information, upload to the cloud and application of IoT as an analysis. So these are the middle section. IoT software platform is the cloud service, and cloud service readily available with us. Some of them are paid and some of these are freely available. So Cumulocity IoT platform from the Microsoft Azure IoT suite, Google Cloud platform, AWS IoT platform, Cisco IoT platform, Oracle IoT platform, IBM IoT platform, ThingSpeak or MATLAB IoT platform. These are the various platforms are available by which we can directly handle our data to upload those data in cloud. So cloud is nothing but the server where the data are storing over there, huge data, big data. So anyhow, we have to send the data over there and retrieve the data for our use or analysis or control purpose. As far as the application concerned, the IoT has different areas. Initially, it has been started in 2010. Only very few equipments were connected over there. Low power and thin batteries, cloud storage, security, smart sensor, healthcare. These were the targeted area at that time for the home and personal. Then in 2015, they have just expanded their area in the field of technology. So the smart antennas, enhanced RFID security and privacy, miniaturization of the readers, cloud computing, energy harvesting, energy analysis, wireless power. These were the other concern towards the IoT application. And in present era, in 2020, we are moving toward the energy harvesting, recycling, large scale wireless sensor, highly enhanced security deployment, and a self-adaptive system, cloud storage, biodegradable materials, and critical infrastructure monitoring. These are the another concern while we are moving towards. So I think everyone has faced this type of situation that they are handling directly to IoT or indirectly IoT, as their mobile phone itself is an IoT sensor and directly fetching the information of their room or their face detection, and they are sending it to the cloud, or they are sharing their photos to the cloud and anybody can see it. So it is one of the example over there. And further in future, we know that we are moving toward the smart technologies. So our vehicles, our vehicle management system must be strong as per as IoT enabled technologies are supporting it. So the smart tech for the logistics and vehicle management, vehicle to infrastructure, system level analysis, autonomous vehicle using IoT services, heterogeneous systems with the interaction between the other sub networks. So smart traffic, automatic driving vehicles, intelligent transport and the logistics. So these are the future in the field of transport. So we will quite obviously we will see the upgradation in future, as all the vehicles in our India also, the government sector is trying to remove the old combustion engine based electrical vehicles and bring new electrical vehicles with a fast charging schemes so that get easily charged with the instant time. Okay, so other factor now they are competing with the time factor that earlier we used to charge it for the 10 or 12 hour, but now we can charge it within 15 minutes or half an hour. Means the time of charging is reduced down, and the automation control, self-driven cars, we are also enabled technologies coming up to cop up the transportation system and making it more and more strong. So in IoT, in electrical vehicles, that from the data we can suggest that in 2015, almost one third of new vehicles in developed country had the internet connectivity. And afterwards, in 2025, more than three-fourths of new vehicles in developed countries are expecting to have internet connectivity. That means every vehicle after, in future, every vehicle will be connected through the internet. So that is the potential of it. Or now it is spreading over the developing countries like us, that will have to adopt the change, the global change in the field of IoT. So the application here for the electrical vehicles is a toll collection, telemetric diagnosis, navigation, infotainment, fleeting management, point number one here discuss that particular advanced driven assistant system. So this is particular system for the automated driving vehicles, EVs, particularly smart charging and power management. So these are the few areas where people can work while they adopt the IoT based systems. So vehicle to safety, the safety measures, vehicle to grid, vehicle to charging stations, intermodal communication, parking management, mobility service, and insurance. So these are the major sectors where we have the influence of IoT. So architecture of IoT, we have in this particular, you can observe that the lower level, this lower section, is it visible to all?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. If you have any doubt or anything, you can just ask me. Okay, so these are the sensors. Okay, sensors may be our temperature sensor, our voltage sensor, radio frequency ID, camera, audio, smoke sensor, or any kind of the sensor which can be suited on our electrical vehicle. And next level is the enterprise, these gateways, enterprises gateway, access gateway, or home gateway. So here are the routers we generally use over there, Wi-Fi routers. So we call them as a home gateway, then access gateway, and the enterprise gateway. So these intermediate hardware is needed to connect information to the network level. And this is network level, or you can see it is a server level or cloud level, where the data is to be stored or ready to communicate with other people or industry or the management system or the analysis. So here our main focus is that to develop such a system having a one sensor, gateway, and cloud. So we can prepare a demo for it. So here, various technologies are available over there. Wireless technologies like 5G, Z-Wave, 6LO, P-WAN. And these are based on the neighbor area network or wide area network or home area network. So these are some area networks are available with the different protocols with the smart technologies like 3G, 4G and 5G. So these are the 5G technologies are now coming up, and BSNL is coming, is taking it up, initiative of it. And we can say that it is technological upgradation, so that everyone will get benefited. So these are the various technologies, and there, see there, the 5G range is given over there. So data rate, it can go up to 10 GB. Right now it is around 5 GB or 2 GB is available over there. But if the 5G network would be there, so 20 GB data transfer rate is possible over there. So distribution and monitoring and control is very easy in this particular system. Z wave, it is range is 30 meter and data is 100 kbps. LOPON, it is a robust low power consumption, support large mesh, it is HAN, it is also for the home network. 250 kbps, 10 to 100 meter is the range. And again, LORA WAN, wide area network, it is also popular for a sub-urban area. It can transfer the covering the range from 2 to 2.5 or 15 kilometer for sub-urban environment. And ZigBee is a locally we can use for the 10 to 100 meters, and energy metering and monitoring, smart lighting, home automation, these are the areas. And Bluetooth low power consumption, it is comes in the group of HAN and range is 1 to 10 meters. And these enable technologies assure that how can we utilize our system in a better way as per the application, either be long distance covering or the complex, that low cost is important, or the complexity of the network is there. So accordingly, we will choose the IoT setup for us. So here for designing aspect, I would just inform you that if you want to design our system, so basic requirement is what? First is sensor, second is network, and third is a data processing and the application layer. So we will start from the sensing layer, then the network layer and data processing. Okay. So have you observed handled some data? If you go for the mechanical system, we just measure the pressure, we just measure the humidity, we just measure the temperature of the vehicles and get the information from it and collect it, and we just save the data using either some software like MATLAB or other things for the further analysis if you go for the offline, isn't it? But here if we are going for the online analysis, so we'll have to take care about the specific sensor, which type of sensor we will use, which kind of the gateway we will use, and which type of network we will use. Okay, so here some protocols we already discussed that which been in application. So for the IoT application, main aspect is that we'll have to choose a protocol which is very lightweight, low power consumption, and use very low data, isn't it? So that all of we are using the WhatsApp. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, just respond to me. I just want to communicate with you all also, isn't it? So don't hesitate to communicate. That's why, so that we can just get something interesting out of it. Otherwise, you feel that it is somewhat boring, isn't it? Because mobile hands-on we are having, and WhatsApp we use generally, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir. So if we are using the WhatsApp, what we think that how this messaging is possible? Although sometimes you feel that if the network connection is very low, isn't it? Your network, internet browser is not opening at the time, but WhatsApp is running. You have feel that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So what is the enable technologies they followed up? So here one basic technology or common technology they followed up, which is the IoT based technology, which is the MQTT. Okay, it is a one telemetry method to transport the information. The full form of MQTT is that message queuing telemetry transport. Okay, that means they just sequence the preference of the client, and according to the preference and the priority, they allot the slot for each individual client to share their information. Okay, so no, there is no clashing between, although lot of huge congestion is there in network, but they do it smoothly, isn't it? So in WhatsApp also they use the MQTT, messaging queuing telemetry. So is this this particular protocol is being used in our system also, which hardware we will make enable UI. So the in the low power consumption is there. So here I have just taken up the advantage of MQTT. It is a messaging transport system. So MQTT is a lightweight protocol that runs on the top of the IP protocols, internet protocols. They use their top of that, means only 2 to 10 bytes rate is required to flow their data. And it eliminates the vulnerable and insecure client connection, because you can say this MQTT is a broker. It's dealing with the one user and another is a server. Okay, so it is a dealing in between that which information should be shared or not. So it is a very safe, eliminates the but an insecure client connection. Can easily scale from single device to thousands device. So it is scalable. That means you can either choose one device, means one sensor like temperature sensor, another view strain sensor, or means speed sensor for the data collection. So thousands of the sensors you can easily connect over there. So it can scale up itself for transferring the data. Manage and track all the client connection status, including the security, reduce the strain over the network. Okay, now we know that basic phenomena which is happening in the network, how they are sharing the information. MQTT is a broker, okay, in between, and one client is our device where we are sharing the information, another client is the cloud. Okay, so it having the sequencing that, okay, publish first request, connect neck, subscribe the temperature, publish. So in the publish, which one is demanding to publish the data first? So it will decided by the client. So client is saying, okay, 25 degree. So it will send only the 25 degree from the fetching the information from the client A, and in this way is thus means manage the sequencing MQTT. And further, how will we design by using these basic concept? First concept is that what? First concept is sensor, or you can say the perception layer, from by which we can sense the data. Second, along with the sensing, there is some MQTT which will share the information from the sensor to the cloud. So that is called the gateway and gateway device. And further, the cloud where this analysis, or the server, you can say big server, our huge data transferring, collection, storage, everything is being done over there. Every information which we share on internet, it is stored in cloud. Okay, afterwards we can retrieve those information by using our own laptop, by industry computer, or the any IoT enabled device, or you can say which is connected by internet. From anywhere of the globe, you can just retrieve the information. Okay, so we are just going to build it by our own. So as suggested, that our first is that sensor. So how sensor is being chosen over here? So I have taken the sensor DHT11. It is a temperature humidity sensor, commonly being used over there and easily available. Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So how many people have used such type of sensors? Temperature sensor, LM35, it is very much popular, or some speedometer, speed sensor, or humidity sensor. So in mechanical engineering also, they use various types of sensor for getting the data. Isn't it? Is it true?
Yeah.
Yeah. So first thing is that to get the data by using sensor. So this particular sensor we are using over there. So in this particular sensor, we are having the three terminals, and three terminals, these three terminals, one is supply, one is ground, and one is the sensing node, or you can say the data transfer. Okay, so here three points are here. That means one is transferring the data, second is the VCC plus volt and minus volt. Okay, so our in this particular here, this is for the data. Is it visible? It is for the data transfer. This is the plus volt and this is the minus volt. Okay, and this is our DHT sensor, and specific property is that 3.5 to 5.5 volt can be connected over there. Operating current is very low, 0.3 millivolt measurable, and it data is transferred in a serial data connection mode. Temperature range we can use it for 0 to 50 degree centigrade, and for more precise or more higher range we can use another kind of sensor, but it is a sensor. It comes within a rupee of 100. So it is very low cost sensor. Humidity it can measure up to 20 to 90%. Temperature resolution and humidity both at a 60 bit memory space over there, and accuracy ±1% degree centigrade for temperature and ±1% for the humidity. So this is the basic information of it. And further, second which we are using is a node MCU. It is a hardware basically used to take the information, or which is directly connected through our sensor and get the information of it. Okay, so it is a next hardware which is required for designing our prototype. Only thing is that we'll have to identify that where is the point for the data and where is the point for the supply, isn't it? So we can observe that these, is it visible to all?
Yes, sir, perfectly.
3.3 volt and ground. This is one supply node, another is a ground and 3.3, and ground and 3.3. So this voltage supply can be connected with the sensor, and one digital input output port we will select over there. Okay, so here we are having a 13 pins. It has the 13 pins, which are the general purpose G PIO. These are called the general purpose input output port. So we are having the general purpose input output port 13 numbers, 13, total number of 13. So from 0 to 16, GPIO 16. So these numbers are available to use it for connecting our data, means our basic sensor. So we'll identify the certain general purpose input output port, and one port we'll select for giving it to the data. And two pins, we know that it has a three pins. So this data pin we will connect with the general purpose input output port. Okay, and this minus terminal is connected to the ground. Okay, and this volt is connected to the 3.3 volt sensor. So this is our scheme to connect it. And so is it clear? So while we select the hardware, we just have to know the different pin configuration over there and where we'll have to connect. So GPI1, GPI0, we will just share it over there. So GPI0, we have chosen over there. So we'll connect to the GPI0 or 1 or 2 or 3. Okay. So here D0 is GPI16 and D2. So digital output input pins are straightway written over there. Okay, D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, this is the 3 volt. It is a ground. It is a D5, D6, D7, like that. So we'll choose the appropriate pin for it. So we have chosen one pin of digital transfer pin and one for positive supply, negative supply. Negative supply here we have taken as a ground. Okay, so now we'll make the connection. So as suggested, supply is connected to the this D4, okay, and VCC is connected with 3.5 and minus is connected with the ground. Okay, and further, so are you getting?
Yes sir.
So make it more clear. To make it more clear, I'll show you the actual hardware. Yeah, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you can see my hand?
Yes.
Yeah. So this one is our, this is our basic sensor. Okay. This particular is our basic sensor, which we have just explained over there. Okay. What's the name of this sensor?
HTD.
Yeah. DT 11. Okay, it is specified. It comes in 12 also. Okay, and this particular device is our MCU node. It is a special device, works on a Arduino board. It's a low cost IoT device which works on a Arduino board. Okay, so it is a combination of the earlier we use. You have heard about that the Arduino board, Arduino Uno. Which generally our students, the UG students use, okay, Arduino board. You have heard about it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now what is happening over there? Now they have combined the Arduino board, GSM board, and the wireless capability of it, and have one single board which is comes as a MCU node 8266. Okay. ESP8266. So this is that particular board. We have just connected this through the USB cable to my computer. So I'll just getting the power supply of it of 5 volt, and internally it is provided to that 3.3 to our sensor. So these data are basically connected that one pin terminal is chosen over there zero, and another set is connected to the plus supply and one is connected to the ground. So in this way, we'll just connect only two things. One is the sensor, one is our module. Okay. So in this way, we have just created our hardware. Then what about the working? How will it work? So we'll have to look after the programming part of it while we go to implement it. If you have programmed the Arduino and you know board or other, are you are familiar with the C programming also, so you can do it. It is very easy programming, and the programming you can also get it from the internet. Okay, from where you type the in the Google, that just programming for the Arduino programming for the MCU node. So they will just give you the program also, and you can just program it with the EDA, the environment of the development software. Okay, so environment development software EDA is the Arduino, and it is available over the, I'm just showing you which kind of EDA is available when you click up the Arduino web server. Okay, so this type of IDE will be available over there. So here you can plan it and program it. Okay, programming. So should I explain programming part also? Are you getting my voice?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Because it is not a big deal. So readily available programs is also available. Only you have to copy from that source and paste over here, isn't it? So that will work. And that is particularly having program part having some sections. I'm just showing it. Yeah. So program of the sending data using the MCU node. So we will just clear cut identify what we are doing over there. So this hum log common program mein karte hain. What we do, we just include the libraries. Okay, so first we include the library over there. So here first thing done, I have include DHT. Second library will include is a ESP8266 Wi-Fi. It is a library for our sensing node. Second is one thing we'll be do is a API key, application interface which on internet we are having. We'll just apply over there. And we use a key, API key, and this key will be generated by creating account. Create account on MATLAB for downloading any software or other purpose. We have an account on MATLAB, so you can just free of cost. You can just create your account, create account over there, MATLAB account using your Gmail ID or any ID. So they will give you at the ThinkSpeak when you register over, they ask for the MATLAB account. Then when you insert in the MATLAB account, you can generate the API key instantly over there for your link, for your mail ID, isn't it? So from there, you can generate the API key and write it here in this script. Okay, and further, this is the your SSID and the password of your router. You'll have to show that this is your password of your network or your connection. Okay, so this thing will be do. This one. Okay, and further the character api.thinkspeak.com, and this is the web server where this perform will be placed on. Okay, so these basic things you will have to make using the net. First is including this one. Second is creating API key, then set the your home network or the office network over here, SSID and password, and set the network. And further, you have to define the PIN. PIN number 0 you have chosen for connecting your sensor.
हेलो हेलो
नितिन सर, आई थिंक वी लॉस्ट हिज वॉइस.
यस सर, यस सर, इवन आई एम नॉट एबल टू हियर हिज वॉइस. आई एम ट्राइंग टू कॉन्टैक्ट हिम.
या
Okay, dear participants, because of some network issue, he was disconnected. He is just going to join in a minute. Okay, dear participants, we have today's third session will be from 1:30 to 2:30. The test will be conducted after the third session. Okay, sir, you are now connected.
Yeah. There was some actually again the heating problem was there. I think my laptop. So I'm sharing the my slides again.
Sure, sir.
Yeah, is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, we are discussing about for the development of the IoT module by which we can send our information or retrieve the information. Okay, so we have net the connection over there. We written over the programming part. Selected the different pin IDs. Here the pin IDs. Pin IDs over there. And further, in by default given the Wi-Fi client node, serial port node, and make the suitable connectivity information over there. Wi-Fi is connected or not, your device is connected or not, for checking it, and the serial monitor display over there for the client print and the serial port output print. So serial port output information would be in degrees, humidity in percentage, and degree centigrade the temperature. So first is temperature T, second is H, so percentage sent to the things speed, and optional stop the client, serial port, and delays 15 second update. Okay, so the data rate and the sample rate will have to fix up over there. So once we get the programming part, we just move to our IDA, environmental development board, where we are just dealing with our ThinkSpeak software, or you can say the cloud. So Arduino utilities developed to dump the programming. So I have just connected the USB kit with my laptop, and I have written the program, and I will dump on my hardware. Okay, so we will connect it with our MATLAB software cloud service. It is the ThinkSpeak, and see the performance, isn't it? It is our main objective. So here I have connected my hardware, and I'm just uploading my data. So it is showing that compiling sketch, and we can see the here the green line. Okay, it is we are ready to dump your program, or you can see the upload the program in our hardware. Okay, once it uploaded, so some information will be created here in this black strip over there, compiling this sketch. Then sketch done, and it is uploaded, so it will show you the uploaded. So it is being done on a real-time basis. So it will just take a few seconds to execute it. And we'll be able to see the information. And in between, we have just created our open up the ThinkSpeak cloud. ThinkSpeak cloud over there, and I'm just registering over there. My registration, I have already registered, so it is directly opened, and it is showing my data which is being uploaded. Okay, so is it visible to all?
Yes.
Yeah, so this is the screen where I have opened up my account on MATLAB and went to the directly ThinkSpeak site. And here different sections are given: private view, public view, channel setting, API key. So once we start with the programming, I said that, okay, generate the API key. So from here, we can just generate the API key. Okay, here it is the API key. And this API key we have used in programming. When I was writing the programming, I have used this API key, and copied from there and pasted here. So it will identify the location of the server, okay, and send the information to it. So now this information, which is being generated in my ThinkSpeak cloud, it can be easily visible over there. I can just see the information gathered. I just find out that what the temperature at this moment. Okay, so temperature at this moment is a 20 degree centigrade, humidity is 69%. Okay, and these are the real time data, and humidity versus temperature plotting is also available with this software. This cloud ThinkSpeak, it will give you the visual representation of your data also. Okay, so you can just visualize over there. If suppose so is it clear how we are getting the data? See, every 15 minutes it is changing the data over here. 15 seconds, because delay we have put up at the 15 seconds. So every 15 seconds it just gives the new data. See that? Are you able to see the variation in graph?
Yes, sir.
So this particular very small setup you can just design by your own to develop your kit which is measuring the temperature, and this temperature can be used to for the health monitoring of your electrical vehicles. Their calculation for the further improvement or any other analysis, isn't it? So here I have just pressed up the sensor for the getting the different values. So see that suddenly it has changed to 95, and temperature variation is also showing over there. So it is the sensors by which we can directly deal with. So I am again back to my presentation. So in this way, we can gather the information using our small hardware setup, which I have shown the demo with the programming part, and the final result we'll get in this form, like temperature and date. Either the solar PV monitoring, you can use the data. You can use the data for the EV monitoring. You can use the data for the system monitoring. You can use the data weather monitoring. Means lot of applications are there by which you can use the ThinkSpeak cloud. So that's all for the my presentation. If you have any query or any questions, you can just ask to me. I'm available here.
So participants, if you have any query or any question, you can ask.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
I have one question. I have put it in the chat box as well. You talked about Node MCU.
Yeah.
So is it similar to Arduino, or can you elaborate the difference between them?
Yeah, yeah. Actually, earlier for making the IoT node or IoT setup, we need the SIM and we need the GSM module and Arduino Uno board, okay, separately, and then we join them together and form a IoT setup. But now what they have done, they have just provide a MCU node, ESP8266. So all the facility of the means Arduino board and the GSM module or the networking system is available in this only one chip, okay, only one module. So it is a very much useful and easy to handle it, okay, and it is also very low cost, means around 800 or 700 you can get it.
Okay, so it has a better communication facility as compared to Arduino.
Communication facility with us, we are the means engineering background. So if you know nothing about the programming part or hardware also, so it is very, very low complex setup. I have shown you just the sensor and thus module only. Okay, by using this, you can transfer your data. Otherwise, there would be a huge complex system is needed to transfer the data, isn't it? So this, if you have this MCU node, so definitely low cost module. So it is upgraded version of that, you can say.
Okay, and it is okay. Okay, good to know that, sir. And the programming language used is C++.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah, thank you all.
So thank you very much, sir, for this wonderful session. We have discussed the following topics in this session. We have discussed about the IoT and its application domain. We discussed about the use of IoT in the electric vehicle. We discussed about the IoT architecture, about MQTT. And we have also seen the IoT programming, how we can do the programming. About the software also, SKG, Think, Speak, Sites, where you can do the programming and you can use it in your project work. So thank you, sir, for this nice session. It was very informative session. And if you want, sir, we can take a 5-minute break, then we can start the second session.
Yeah, definitely. We'll be together after 6-7 minutes.
So there is a short break after 5 minutes, five or six minutes.
We will have 5 to 10 minutes. You can have the break. There's no problem at all.
Sure. Yeah. At 11:20, we meet.
Yeah.
Thank you, everyone.